me tell you, keeping it real, keeping it rude. It's through the eyes of Rue, keeping it real.
It's the RoCKeT QuEEnS!
Yeah! I am Nikki. I actually play keyboard in the band, so...
This is our Disney rookie.
The weird
teen
buddy.
Yeah!
She plays the beat now.
Well, you are fucking badass, as we already know. We know, but it's...
You know, we've met before. My name's Lily. I play Slash in the group.
Yeah, and you are a shredder as well.
I am a shredder.
Didn't you win a shred award or something?
I did. It's been a few years, but I did.
Yeah!
I know. She's like, Miss Badass.
That's the last time I was on here.
Yeah. Like, you went flying, playing, shredding.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was on these scissor lifts. That was like another thing. Like,
I forget everything, but I did not forget that.
That was like 5 years ago. That was like how I fell back in love with playing rock and roll, actually. I've just been playing jazz, and someone had called me and said, like, I hear you grew up on heavy metal, and we have the shred competition as part of the Mock Olympics. So that would have been like 6 years ago, maybe, like Mock Winter Olympics. It's been a minute. Do you want to get on this scissor lift and like shred for a little bit through one of those cheesy pot things? And I was like, oh, yeah, I do. So I got up there, and it all just sort of like came flooding back, like my childhood rock and roll history. And I placed in that one, and then I won something after that, and was like, you know, I've really got to get back into this. So I started this band, and here we are.
RoCKeT QuEEnS. And you, my love, Miss Patience.
I'm Allison. I play Izzy.
And Miss Cheater on your phone.
Now, what would you do?
I don't own a phone.
Axel,
I was taking selfies when I was sick. So that's what was going on.
What's your name?
My name's Magdalena.
Where are you from?
I was born in Poland.
Queer.
That's the only word you know?
Yeah.
How do you say apple pie in Polish?
Tell me.
No, you
you're so into your apple pie that
I thought you know how to say it in all the different languages.
Oh, I wish I could produce that for you. But I was in Poland.
Oh, yeah.
I know how to say vodka.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Now we're talking.
Yeah. Oh, I had the best time in Warsaw, and I can tell you, I have skeletons in Poland. Well, the apple pie is for sharing a skeleton from your closet.
Do you know what that means, Margaret?
No.
Okay, so a skeleton in the closet is when, let's say, like, you kill
somebody. Before you say that, like, every time we do something, there are people that are, like, teaching me English and explaining me how to, like, say words and
phrases. But you speak English
perfect.
She does.
Only
she's
when
like
I
very
say.
English.
Only
no,
when
even when you're speaking.
When I speak like shit.
So,
and
so
if I have a lot of vodka that you talk about,
yeah,
there's no way you can ever like communicate.
How long have you been in New York?
In New York?
Yes.
14 years.
Oh, you're an American. Do you love New York?
I fucking love it.
Yeah!
And I'm not going back to Varsovia, no way.
Yeah.
Unless Obama comes after me and like kicks the fuck out of me.
No, you have to stay a RoCKeT QuEEnS.
So a couple of weeks ago we were on the road and we had sort of an educational bit about the difference between the munchies and what a munchkin is. And a munchkin is like a little donut. And the munchies are when you get drunk
when you'll
whatever
eat
you
the apple
snack.
Pie.
So today's educational language bit is when a skeleton's in the closet.
Yes.
So that's like, it's code for a secret, but it comes from the idea that let's say you killed somebody and you hid the body and it turned into a skeleton.
Well,
you're,
I kind of thought
that's where it comes from?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's how I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What
I thought,
what
you,
do I know?
When somebody finds out a skeleton in the closet, it means they've gone, you know, digging through your house and they found something that you've been hiding for a long time.
What I thought it was she just like used those Polish motherfuckers so badly that they all died.
No! I had the best time in Poland.
Really?
I mean, yes,
I'm sure it was not with men.
So basically she hit the bodies, and then
it's not always about death in my book.
You know, so it's about a secret that you don't bring out much.
Like,
yeah.
Did you ever steal something? Did you ever, like...
No.
So my skeleton, if you want to just get it out of the way, is that I like have had a very long-term musical love affair with Steely Dan.
I did.
Everybody's really excited about that, but like
for you, it's not.
Here
that
I am. I'm like this tattoo, you know, like rock and roll.
Yeah.
Steely Dan are my favorite band in history.
My voice.
Wow. Really?
Yeah.
Well, have some apple pie.
I have some pie.
Yeah. All right. Can we get a better one from you?
Hear it.
I'm not telling any dirty secrets.
No, not you.
Okay.
Not you.
Wow.
Yeah.
There are some things I can't tell.
But that's the best one.
I will tell you that I love David Bowie.
Oh.
Yeah!
Okay, now. Have a good time.
Thank you. closet.
Yeah.
I put him in the closet.
And what happened? Did you ever get caught?
No.
Was it a friend? I guess not.
More like Northern California, like super relaxed, like
hippie girl,
like,
right?
Yeah. So, you know,
yeah.
I put a pastor or whatever.
Okay, was it before the tie-dye or after? Did you drink the Kool-Aid that day?
Yes.
You drank the Kool-Aid. How's the metal pie? Would you like to tell, do you have any brothers or sisters?
Yes.
Did you ever torment one?
Did what?
Did you ever do anything mean to your brother or your sister?
Of course.
So what did you do? What was the worst thing?
Of course, I'm like the oldest one, so obviously.
So what was the worst thing?
Torturing all of them.
What was the worst thing you ever did to them?
Oh my God, why do you bring this up?
Yeah!
Well, first of all, like, my brothers are younger than me, and for some reason, like, they have no, like, physical boundaries, so if you come and hang out with my family, you're going to see my brothers, like, touching my tits and my ass and stuff like that, so that's one thing. But, like, me and my sister, we used to, like, beat the shit out of each other.
Who won?
So, I mean, we never won. It was always nasty. Like, I don't even know. You just brought it into my head because I was going to say something else that's, like, my skeleton, but all of a sudden, you brought me back to, like, being five and... If you have a sister, you have to beat the crap out of her, right?
I'm 10 years older than my sister, so
I
probably would have gotten to jail.
My sister and I are
like
9 months apart.
But now you're friends, right?
Me and my sister are like 9 months apart. Like,
my mom,
my
God.
I don't think she even healed, and she already got to
Wow, that's very close. Were you in the same grade at school?
No.
So you were one ahead?
Yeah.
So are they all in Poland?
My sister's here, my brothers are in Europe, yes.
Nice.
She's
so
there.
Do you have any kids
I hope there's
up?
Something in
the
room.
Actually, now that you mention it. So we're on the road most of the time, so we don't play in New York very often.
I'll play your tambourine. I want to go on the road.
It's been crazy. We have so many crazy road stories at this point. It's like, we were put up in a whorehouse by accident in Cincinnati.
By
accident?
Yeah, it was like a day's in. It was like the cheapest hotel the promoter could find. And God bless them, they were the nicest people. They
of
just
course.
Didn't know
I was
doing.
So drunk and passed out, I never heard anybody fucking.
Yeah, but I
forget, you don't even know what happened.
Like, the number of, like, cars that were running in the parking lot with, like, two people. It was an adventure. I'm sorry, Nikki's family. Keep telling these stories.
My dad.
Nikki's family's watching.
Oh, God.
We're out of town most of the time. So we had a rare weekend off, and we work with CEG a lot. They've been really good to us, and so they asked us if we wanted to play at Fontana's, and we said yes.
Sure.
So we're headlining Fontana's on Saturday.
Nice.
I think it's only $10. It's a full band.
It's my birthday.
It's
yeah.
Birthday. So y'all should come. We'll play like an hour. We'll play a lot of the hits and a couple of deep cuts. And that's we have amazing drummer, amazing bassist. You couldn't be here today, so if you want to hear the whole thing plugged in, you know, it's worth it.
So has anyone from Guns N' Roses ever like?
We know a few.
Did they love you guys?
We're opening for Dizzy on January 3rd.
That's what I would imagine.
We're opening for Dizzy Reed.
He heard us and he approached actually Lily and asked us to open for him.
So he and Nikki have
next
met.
Step,
hug.
Next
so
step slash. I'm putting it
yeah,
on record. Next step slash. Slash is going to
have a really great father daughter talk because he has a daughter who's sort of a budding musician and I was raised by a musician. And so I got to go to his daughter's first gig, which was really cool. Nikki, you were there too, right? You took a picture, yeah. And it was really cool because it was her first gig ever. She just started playing the guitar like 3 months ago. And Dad was like, it's just so punk rock that she's out here playing now. I just want to support it. And he sat on the front of the stage and watched with this just like so intense. And
he's
I remember my like little guitar playing, my actually very tall guitar playing dad coming to all of my gigs when I was like 13.
Yeah.
And playing with my talent shows.
Yeah,
well.
My daughter's playing gigs now.
Yeah.
And he was my guitar teacher, so he'd sit in the front row and be super supportive, and then afterwards he'd be like, we really need to talk about your time. But everything he said was like really loving and really helpful.
And
he
look
still,
what happened
like,
to you.
Looks on our YouTube videos and is like, that one's matching.
Oh!
But he's always right. He's always right.
Of course.
He's the best
well,
he
did that so. Lead pretty freaking bad. So, Rocket Queens, would you like to push a button?
I don't know what that means.
Oops. You push a button.
I'm always pushing buttons.
Of course you are.
Yeah.
That sounds about right.
Yeah.
All right. Give it up for the RoCKeT. You gotta come back. You gotta come back. We had so much fun. Thank you. We'll be right back.
Okay. Rew and who? What's that you say? Keeping it real. What's that you say? Keeping it real. Keeping it you. What's that you say? Keeping it real. Keeping it rude. What's that you say? And who? What's that you say?